nice new week. I hope this week goes well with all of you. Right? Now today, we are going to expand more on the Pruno model that we have been studying. In the last class, we learned something fundamentally important. That is, if there are firms which are engaged in Pruno competition, that is, they are producing identical products and competing with choosing the optimal quantities to sell. So each firm decides simultaneously, independently of others, how much is what quantity the firm is going to sell in the market in order to maximize profits. Then they realize that even if one of the firms experiences a large decline in marginal cost, the market price might not fall that much. Right? And the reason, of course, is that because when one firm experiences a large decline in marginal cost, the optimal response function that firm dictates that the firm increase its output. And because the first firm increases its output, the reaction function for the second firm dictates that it reduces its output. And therefore the total market output goes down. Right? Okay? And therefore the market price does not fall as much as it would. Sure? Okay? So one of the important findings of this is that if firms are competing with quantities, then just an technological improvement to one of the firms does not lead to corresponding price reduction for everybody. Right? It is the example of, say, cardiac stents. Right? We actually had somebody who, a researcher who said that because I'm going to produce cardiac stents at 50 rupees a stent, they'll actually be available to customers at 50 rupees because that's the cost of production and firms will charge the cost of production, and therefore there'll actually be large gains to customers, to the ultimate consumers, if my research is funded by the government, might not really work. Sure? So that's, you know, if you have to evaluate these claims, the reverse thing goes. Okay, so now let's go back to our fisherman example. We have these two fishermen. We have these two fishermen who are fishing with bait. Right? Who are fishing with bait. And they are facing the same demand curve. So the demand curve in the market is, say, P is 20 minus Q. Okay? QA is the fish caught by the first fisherman. QB is the fish caught by the second fisherman. This could actually as well be firms, right? But the example of fishermen is just a kind of a paradigm, but this could be a very general kind of thing. You could fit it in different places. Okay. Now, suppose both the fishermen have the same marginal cost C. Okay? The same marginal cost C. But the first fisherman goes and buys a more efficient rod, fishing rod. Right? Fisherman B goes and buys an expensive fishing rod. But he still leaves the same marginal cost. Right? He has to put the same earthworm to the fishing rod, attached to the hook, so as to catch fish. So his marginal cost is not going to change. All that's going to happen is going to have a better, stronger fishing rod. Right? Instead of using those bamboo poles, he goes and imports a fishing rod. He's going to fish with this fishing rod. Right? Do you think the market would change? Do you think anything would happen to the profits of the two individuals, the market prices, quantities, fish? What do you think would happen?
The quantity fish would increase on the person who buys a better rod.
The quantity fish would increase on the person who has got a better fishing rod? Yeah, because he's got a more, he's got a sturdier and a stronger fishing rod. Now the marginal cost remains the same. You think that happen? What do others think? She thinks that the number of fish caught will increase. What do others think?
He might also increase his price slightly.
She thinks that he might also increase his price slightly. But look at, they're selling the identical products. So one of them can't raise the price above others, right? Would you pay more for a fish, more for pumpkins, if just because the person who catches the pumpkins is actually using the more sophisticated technology? No, right? But let's understand what's happening. Let's understand. If she's saying that he will catch more fish, maybe not the price. Do you agree with her? How many of you agree that a better fishing rod would actually lead to more fish being caught by the fisherman? She thinks yes?
That's right.
Yeah?
It will increase.
He thinks it will increase? What do others think? Yes? You also think it will increase? Okay, so let's evaluate this. Okay, so this is right. Cost function for the first fisherman. CA is simply C into Q. Why? Because you are assuming that those rods etc. are available for free. Then he gets to go to a bamboo tree and cut the bamboo and then just start fishing. Right? Okay? For the second fisherman, the cost is since 5 is CQ, where 5 is the cost of the rod. Right? 5 is the cost of the rod. Okay? So this is the cost structure for the second fisherman, the cost structure for the first fisherman. Right? Now, let's look at what is the profit maximizing quantity for the first fisherman. Right? So what is the cost maximizing quantity? So let's look at the revenues of the first fisherman. The revenues of the first fisherman are total revenue of the first fisherman is P into QA minus total cost of the first fisherman. This is equal to total revenue minus CQ. Let's put C at equal to 1. What's it? To be C is equal to 1. Right? This would be, so this is total revenue for the first fisherman. Total profits for the first fisherman. Right? Total profits for the first fisherman. And sorry, by A, total profits for the first fisherman. Total revenue minus total cost. Right? Let me now. How does it solve for the profit maximizing quantity? Differentiation. So this was opened up as two Q A square minus Because the marginal cost is 1. 5 minus QE. Right? Which is? But C there was QB 1. C there was QB 1. So 20 QB. So now, what would be the reaction function? Yeah? So, the reaction function for QB would be same as the first equation.
Yeah.
Right? So if you solve this, what will happen? You get equal quantities. Right? And because the price is the same, right? Now what about profits? Right, okay. So we have got this. Sure? Okay? We have got this. So what will be QA and QB now? Can you solve QA and QB friend? Can you solve for QA and QB?
Yes.
So 3 by 4 cube is QE is 19 upon 4 minus 19 upon 8 is 19 upon. So what's 19 upon 4?
19 upon 8.
What is 19 upon 4? 4.7. Minus 19 upon 8. Point 7 minus
2.2.
Something. What would this be?
2.4.
So QA. Yeah? So 3 by 4 QA is 2.4. So what would be QA?
19.
Yeah? 4.3 into 2.4
is bigger? Yeah, 3.4.
Now, what will QB? What will QB? The price in the market would be P is equal to 20 minus 2. So this is some technological improvement has happened for one fisherman. What do you think will happen to prices, quantities, and all those kinds of things? How will you analyze that? This is how, this is what you do with microeconomics. You try to understand these situations and work. The question is, the fisherman now who has got a sophisticated rod realizes that his margin cost has not gone down. So he goes and buys an even more sophisticated rod, which costs more, but which now has an artificial earthworm as a bait attached to the fishing rod, right? So an earthworm is a very lifelike earthworm. And once it's put into the water for fishing, there's a button on the fishing rod which you press, the earthworm actually wiggles like in real life and actually catches, you can catch fish. Which means that you don't have to buy any more earthworm than margin cost, right, to put onto your home. Right? So it gives you, it reduces, it puts your margin cost to zero. But the fixed cost is now $10, right? So how do you analyze this situation?
The cost
of what do you think will happen to the market? What do you think will happen to the market? Will the total output in the market increase?
No.
Will it or will it not? Let's see how much. Let's see how much the total output in the market increases, what happens to the market price, what happens to profits, and so on and so forth. Right? Okay.
It will change.
It will change?
Yeah, it will change.
How will it change? So all of you are saying it will change marginally. Why would it change marginally? Think of what we did in the last class. Think of this, the cardiac stents example. An identical thing is happening here, right? When the cost of production of one firm goes down, the firm increases output. Which means that the total price in the market drops. Which means that it is optimal for the second firm to reduce its output. And the total market output will not increase that much. Right? So the number of fish caught will not increase, will only increase marginally, not dramatically. Okay? And because the increase in the fish is only small, it's only a small amount, the price might also not fall so much. Right? Okay? Will you be able to work this out on paper? You feel confident of doing this on the back of a, back of envelope kind of a calculation? How would you do it if I wanted to do this here? If I wanted to put numbers really in place, what will I do?
So, you just change the margin cost of the second firm.
Yeah. So, what will happen is, you will say, this remains the same. Right? This remains the same. Okay? Cost function for the first firm remains the same. CQC. Right? Cost function for the second firm is 10, which is the cost of the fishing rod, plus zero marginal cost. Yeah? So it just becomes CB. It should actually have been CQA. This is also CQA, where I should be here C is equal to 1, and in this case C is equal to 0. So CB is equal to 10. Right? So what would be the profit function for the first player? For the first player, you will have pi A is 22A. Minus 2a square. Total revenue minus cost. Sure. So this will be. Okay? And that's the reaction function. Or ethanol content is going to increase. For the second producer, so this is QA. For the second producer, what will be the profit function? Minus 10. So drop the original cost. Right? So right? So
next.